Hello student, in the last lecture we have seen vertical cone which is penetrated by the horizontal cylinder, but the condition was both the axes are bisecting with each other. Now in this problem we will study the second case, that is vertical cone is penetrated by the cylinder but there is some gap between the two axes. Now let us study. I will read the problem and stepwise we will solve it, we will draw it. We will project it, we will understand the geometry, we will understand the projection, we will understand the transferring of the points. A cone, base diameter 70 mm and axis height 65 mm is kept on the HP on its base. This is the first sentence. From this sentence, we can draw the projections of the cone. It is resting on its base on HP. So, the top view will be a circle, the front view is a triangle and the side view is a triangle that we have already seen, studied. In the last lecture, it is penetrated by the horizontal cylinder. Horizontal cylinder, it means that horizontal cylinder means the axis is parallel to both HP and VP and perpendicular to side view plane. They are given the dimension diameter, that is 35 mm diameter. The axis which is parallel to VP and condition here 20 mm above the base of the cone. The axis, horizontal axis of the cylinder is 20 mm above the base of cone. Axis of cylinder is 5 mm in front of the axis of cone. Full stop. Draw the projections of the solids showing curve of intersection. Now, from the first sentence, we can draw as this solid cone is resting on its base on HP. This is HP. This is VP. Resting on its base on HP. So the first true shape, that is top view, is a circle, XY line, circle, this is axis OP, OP, this is the center line. What will be the front view? Front will be the triangle, they will give the axis height, this is O dash, P dash. Projection line, if I name it as A, B, C, D, this is A, B, C, front side, this HP is rotated, this is the XY line, A dash, B dash, C dash, and this is the D dash, then the X1, Y1 line, we have to transfer it here. This is the axis. O dash, P dash. This is the point T double dash. This is point C double dash and A double dash. This is the point B double dash. Now, what does the second sentence mean? First, here I have drawn, look at this figure, first I have drawn the center line, this is the point OP. I have taken a compass, what is the radius? 35 mm. I have drawn the circle, that is the blue color. This is axis OP, I will name it aside, A, B, C, D. This is axis height, what is the axis height? 65 mm. This is A dash, B dash, C dash, as well as D dash. Then we have to draw the side view by taking into consideration. This will be your point D double dash. This will be your point A double dash, C double dash, and axis OP. This will be your point B double dash. Now let us read the second statement. It is penetrated by the horizontal cylinder of 35 mm diameter. The axis of it is parallel. This axis is parallel to VP. This is the cylinder penetrated in this cone. Here I will show the model. This is the core, it is penetrated by the horizontal cylinder. This is the front side. This is the top side, half side. The axis, now we will draw the, what is the axis relation? The axis of the horizontal, this is the axis of the vertical cylinder. This is the axis of the vertical cylinder. The axis of horizontal cylinder, they are given the distance at 5 mm. And it is parallel to which plane? It is parallel to VP. This blue color is the axis of the horizontal cylinder, parallel to VP. Okay. It is penetrated by the horizontal cylinder of 35 mm diameter, the axis of which is parallel to VP and 20 mm above the base of the cone. This is the base of the cone, 20 mm above. At what distance? At 20 mm above. I will draw the center line. Okay. 20 mm above the base of cone, the axis of cylinder, this is the axis of the cylinder now. UV, single point, where it is obtained? We have to draw the distance, at a distance of 5 mm, we have to draw the center line. This is the point UV at a 5 mm and then we have to draw the circle. Then we have to transfer. This is the front view and this will be your, this is the axis, this is 5 mm gap. Here I have drawn just, this is the axis at a distance of 5 mm. I have drawn a vertical center line. Here is the point UV axis. This axis is transferred. This is the UV. This axis again transferred here. This is the UV. Okay. Now I will draw the circle. What is the diameter of the circle? The diameter of the circle is 35 mm. That is total 17.5 mm in the compass, and I will draw a circle divided into 8 equal parts by 45 degree, by keeping the compass by 45 degree. I will name it as 1 1 2 2 3 3 4 4 5 5 6 6. This is the point 7, 7 and 8, 8. Just I will transfer the point here. This is the point 7, 7. This is the point 7, 7. I will transfer the name 7 to 7. Here are two points. 6 dash 8 dash. 6 dash 8 dash. 8 is front side, exactly back side, 6 side. 1 dash, 5 dash, 1 dash, 5 dash, 2 dash, 4 dash, 2 dash, 4 dash, 3 dash, 3 dash. Similarly, this is the rectangle which they have not mentioned the axis length. Just from this base, we have to extend the line. Means 5 mm extension should we have to take and take that distance into consideration. Similarly, what will be the top view of this horizontal cylinder? Here we have to transfer, that will be also the rectangle. This is the point 5, 5. Here are the two points. Six and four. Here is a point 3, 7. Here is a point 2, 8. Here is a point 1, 1. First, I will mark the center point with this color, which is very important, where the metallic pointer of the compass we are placing and marking on the generator. Which distance we are taking into the compass? From the front view, from the center line O, which distance I have taken, metallic pointer on the center line of cone, up to the end slant generator, which is the generator 7-7 from central line up till the end generator of the cone on the generator 7-7. I will come in the top view. Where I have kept the metallic pointer, that is on OP, circle center only. I will mark to 7-7 generator. 7-7. This is P7, Q7. Second point, 6 and 8 from the center on the generator 6 and 8. 6, here is 8. This side 6, here is 8. I will name it simultaneously. This is P8. This is P6. This is Q6. And this is Q8. Next. One and five. 5-1 P side. One five. 5-5-1-1. I will name P1, P5, Q1, Q5. Two and four. I will name it as P2, P4, Q4, Q2. This is 3. Center of the circle. Here this is a point 3-3. P3, Q3. Now we have to transfer this point, as you have seen in the last lecture. P5 is 5, on the 5 I will draw the projection line. For P6, P4, you have transferred P5, this will be the point P5. Six. P6. This is the point 4 on the 4-4 generator. P4. In this way, we have transferred all the point, that is 8 points on the P side, and 8 points. These 8 points have been transferred in the front to on the Q sides. Now the condition is axis is eccentric. So this M and N will be introduced here. This is the M and this is the point N. Where the M and N lies on OD and OC. OD and OC. A and this is A. This is point A double dash and C double dash. This is the point B double dash. This is point A, C. O A and O C. O A and O C. Where is O A? In the front to O A and O C. Just we have to transfer this point. I'll draw the projection line.
Now, where that point lies, MNN, OA and OC. OA, this is OA. So, I will mark it here, M. Here, on OC, M. This is point N. This is point N. Now, we will draw the curve. This is the front sides. 3, 2, 1, 8, 7. 3, 2, 1, 8, 7 is front side. And 3, 4, 5, 3, N, 4, 5, 6 and 7 is the back side that will be dotted. First we will draw a dark curve. 3. Where is 3? 3. 3. After 2, 1, after 1, 8, after 8, 7. Now after 7, backside 7, M, after M, 6, after 6, 5, after 5, 4, this is P2 and this is P4, after 4, N, and 3. Three, two, one, eight, and 7. This will be dark. 7, M. Dotted. After M. 6. After 6. 5. After 5. 4. This will be dotted. After 4, N. And 3. Now this portion. Will dotted. This will be the dark portion. This portion is the dark portion. Now we'll draw the curve. This is the top side. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, which is seen to the other on the top. We are in the top view. Which is top side? 5, 6, 7, 8 and 1. 5, 6, 7, 8 and 1. Which is the bottom side? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. That is not seen to the observer. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In the bottom side, from the top it is not seen. 5, 6, 7, 8. 6, 7, 8 and 1. That is seen to the observer. This portion is dotted. This will be the dark portion. This portion will be dotted. This is the dark portion of the cylinder. This part is not seen, it will be dotted. Okay. In this way, we have to draw the curve where a sense edge we have to make. That is, O vertical cone penetrated by the horizontal cylinder, and there is offset between the two axes, but is not crossing the boundary. Okay. Thank you.